it's often useful to know where a function is positive or negative. And you'll actually use this skill a lot in Calculus 1 once you learn about the derivative. And one of the most common ways to determine this information, that is, where a function is positive or negative, is by use of what we'll call a sign chart. So in this video, we're going to create a sign chart to determine where f of x equals x squared plus 2x minus 3 is positive and where it's negative. So let's go through the steps of how you would create such a sign chart. So I'm just going to draw a random function here, a very wiggly function. So this function is positive in some places and it's negative in some places. And when I say the function is positive, what I mean by that is that it's above the x-axis, or that is that its y values are positive. So let me just outline in blue here the places where my example function is positive. Okay, and then the function is negative at the places where its y values are negative. So I'll outline those places in red for us. So the important thing to realize here is that a function changes from positive to negative, or vice versa, at its zeros, or at its x-intercepts, right? A function has to pass over the x-axis to change from positive to negative. So we're going to use that idea to help us create our sign chart. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our function and we're going to set it equal to 0. And we're going to solve for the x values where this is equal to 0. And that'll give us the places where our function might change from positive to negative. So then I'm trying to solve this equation, x squared plus 2x minus 3 equals 0. Now this is a relatively simple equation. It's just a quadratic. I might try to factor it. And in this case, this actually does factor nicely into x minus 1 times x plus 3, so that I end up with solutions of x equals 1 and x equals negative 3. So what we've just found are our zeros, or our x-intercepts. So I'm going to take this information and I'm going to construct the skeleton of a number line. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these zeros and I'm going to place them on my number line. I mean, these are x values, right? Negative 3 and 1. These are the possible places where my function might change signs. So in this particular example, I've got two x-intercepts. So I've essentially divided my number line into three intervals here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just check the sign of the function on each of those intervals. So let me show you what I mean. Let's start with this interval here. I'm going to pick a test value in that interval. It doesn't matter which value I pick. So I'm going to pick negative 4. And I'm going to take negative 4, so we can put our test values out to the side here. I'm going to take x equals negative 4, and I'm going to plug it in to my original expression. I can use this x squared plus 2x minus 3, or I can use the factored form. It doesn't matter. And I'm just going to see what the sign of the function is at x equals negative 4. Okay, so I'm going to plug in negative 4 to the factored version. So I have negative 4 minus 1 times negative 4 plus 3. Okay, I don't care what the actual value is. I only care about what the sign is. So it looks here that I have a negative times a negative. Oops, a negative times a negative. We're just going to give me a positive overall. So then what that tells me is that on this interval, my function is positive. And then I'm going to do the same thing for my other intervals. And for any one of these given intervals, it's always going to be the same sign on the whole interval, because once again, I can only change the sign of my function if I pass through a zero. So let's pick another test point. This time we're going to do this middle interval, so I need something between negative 3 and 1. So I could pick 0, that'd be a good one. Once again, I'm going to plug it into my factored form, and I don't care about the value, I just care about the sign. So here it looks like I get a negative times a positive, so a negative overall. And then I have one more interval. Pick a test value, I could use x equals 2. If I plug that in to my factored form here, I get a positive times a positive, so that's a positive overall. So then let's make some conclusions. So we can say f of x is positive on the intervals from negative infinity to negative 3, union 1 to infinity. Notice that I'm not actually including negative 3 and 1 in my intervals. I'm using parentheses here. At those values, the function is 0, so it's not positive. And then I can also say f of x is negative on the interval from negative 3 to 1. And let's just verify this on a graph to make sure we understand what's going on here. So here's my function, y equals x squared plus 2x minus 3, and as we expect, it's a parabola. And I've lined up my number line underneath here, so we can compare what we got to the graph. So I see that my zeros were correct. I have a 0 at negative 3 and a 0 at 1. And then my function is positive to the left of negative 3 here, and then to the right of x equals 1, just like we discovered on our number line. And then my function is negative between negative 3 and positive 1. So a sign chart then, once again, is just a really useful way to figure out where a function is positive and where it's negative. And the function we looked at here is pretty simple, but you can use this same method for more complicated functions.